If Romney is really considering running for president in the future, there will be no way he's going to pass clearance. No matter how many records George Bush Sr. and others may change, information regarding his stolen Falcone funds will be splashed all over the world. He will not get on first base. Every detail of all activities, including named banks, accounts, dates, and complicit parties involved in this corruption, will be shared with congressional members. A congressional panel will be interviewing past and present administrations because evidence will warrant their actions. Mr. Falcone's sources revealed that when former President George Bush Sr. orchestrated the government-sponsored team that flew to Germany in September, they met with Bush Sr. criminal associate Michael Herzog. During the meeting, Bush Sr.'s team told Herzog that he and his partner Paul Gwinnett can't discuss or ever confirm their association with the Bushes and Mitt Romney. Michael Herzog told Bush Sr.'s team it was Bush Sr. and Romney's decision not to settle and pay Falcone. Why are you telling me to settle now? Tell Bush Sr. if he tries to make me reimburse Falcone now, I will expose all Bush's and Romney's offshore accounts in billions in offshore accounts, including links, source records, and earnings we've earned together. Mr. Falcone believes that Herzog's threat and blackmail caused Bush Sr. to order his team to move and change bank accounts in other countries to protect him and Romney from Falcone, Herzog and associates to try to protect their stolen funds. President Obama was informed about the Falcone matter and the need to settle by Mr. Falcone's sources and directly by Dennis Blair, former lead member of Obama's Security Council, who stepped down this past summer. So many records, similar high-value cases of grand scale of fraud and supporting evidence have been provided to the president. The president's full knowledge of the Falcone matter and other similar cases are considered a dereliction of duty and fiduciary care of the office he holds. To this date, President Obama has failed to respond to other parties or to take any action regarding the Falcone's settlement. But Obama's administration managed to immediately step in to help the Clintons, who Herzog had also stolen funds from. Funds the Clintons will be obligated to explain to Congress under oath. Michael Herzog and partner Paul Gwinnett stole substantial money from the Clintons' trading activities, and government agencies immediately brought Herzog and Gwinnett to Washington, D.C. for a hearing that's not on public record, but held in a field file. They made Herzog and Gwinnett reimburse all of the Clintons' money in a private recovery deal with the agencies. There is a growing case of fraud, bribery, corruption, theft, misuse of agency powers, and failure of the FBI and other government agencies to investigate and arrest the parties involved with the theft of Mr. Falcone's settlement funds and with many others. Cover-ups are about to be exposed. Mr. Falcone is currently interviewing prominent criminal attorneys to take action against the U.S. government, the Bushes, and Mitt Romney personally for corruptly blocking investigations. Mr. Falcone filed with the FBI, Homeland Security, and the Federal Reserve Board, and for their constant interfering and derailing of the return of Mr. Falcone's funds. A key will be, why are the Bushes and Romney associates with known criminals like Herzog and Paul Gwinnett? A full public audit of all accrued income will be demanded. In addition to legal actions being taken by Mr. Falcone, more congressional members are being enlisted and given all particulars, including incriminating account information. This information is now with numerous key EU agencies, newspapers, and Chinese banks and officials. Senior European ministers are being advised of the scale of corruption and criminality of named parties. A number of key independent media agencies, such as WikiLeaks, will explode this globally, naming and shaming the criminal parties, enabling the American electorate to judge and act. This is heading for a Nuremberg scale of trial. Mr. Falcone reports that once again Bush Sr. sent out a team to change Biden's accounts in Hong Kong. They changed banks and the names on Biden's accounts. Each team member's names are known with full details of their travel itinerary. When President Obama was in India, he received formal notification of Joe Biden's clandestine involvement with Bush Sr., who was the party behind stealing Falcone's funds, and with whom Bush Sr. cross-utilized Clinton to bribe Biden to assist and deny Falcone's recovery of his funds. Mr. Falcone's sources report that Obama confronted Joe Biden about the money he received, corruptly, from the stolen Falcone settlement and about his other account at Bank Santander, Spain. Obama advised Biden that in addition to his account in Hong Kong, his Santander account had been discovered and to move it immediately, which Biden took care of electronically. Because the president knew about this corruption, but took no action to rectify it and uphold the law, instead freely choosing to help Biden attempt to conceal the truth, he's as culpable as the other criminals. He also knows of other similar activities and has taken no action, which is considered a dereliction of duty and fiduciary care of the office he holds. Bush Sr. knows that Falcone and the authorities are carefully monitoring his and Biden's accounts in particular. That's why the Bush team did not dare go back to Spain or the Caribbean during this last trip overseas. What this criminal team of spooks and agents fail to grasp is that every move is known and recorded. Also known during Bush Sr.'s team previous trip is that he had his money moved from St. Bart's and relocated to other Caribbean island banks. Intelligence reports states that Bush Sr.'s team is expected to be back in the States this week. These parties are not going to steal assets from Ed Falcone, an American citizen, and get away with it. A catalog of evidence has been collated encompassing RICO fraud, bribery, corruption, money laundering, theft, misuse of agency powers, and the systematic failure and collusion of the FBI and other government agencies to investigate and arrest the parties involved with the theft of Mr. Falcone's settlement funds. Mr. Falcone has been interviewing high-level criminal attorneys to add to his legal team, who will be filing personal criminal charges against Bush, both Bushes, Mitt Romney, Michael Herzog, Paul Gwinnett, Joseph Ackerman, Alan Greenspan, and others. In conjunction with anticipated congressional hearings, criminal charges will also be filed against all of Bush Sr.'s team who changed and modified bank records to help cover up Falcone's stolen funds. The scale, dynamic, and global economic implications of this sordid affair are of such significance, it is now being tracked by multiple enforcement agencies, media sources, and key intel agencies. Knowing every move is being tracked, and yet again their accounts are compromised, instead of paying Falcone what is due, long overdue, George Bush Sr. now again plays games with his Bermuda, Turks, and Caicos accounts, holding money he robbed and defrauded from Falcone and others, moving it to money laundering banks, receiving it are open to money laundering charges. So are their staffs. Capone, a cheap Chicago hood, was brought down with simple tax evasion. Whatever it takes, Romney has dreams of the Oval Office, supported by Senior's patronage. His payoffs, linked with Michael Herzog, will be his own Achilles heel. He accepts Senior as his mentor, his ticket to ride. Neither understand, in this high-tech world, wherever they move it to, we can and will track it. Every dollar leaves footprints and skid marks. Every move we watch and trace.
The heroic fight with us. The honest support us. The corrupt fear us. For we are anonymous. We are legion. We do not forget. We do not forgive. Expect us to expose you.